And now it's my pleasure to introduce a very special Christmas edition of On the Ball, not introduced as usual by Ian St. John, but by much younger, prettier poof called Jim Rosenthal.
Well, thanks very much, Dickie. You're very kind, and I look forward to your next personal appearance, Dickie speaking at the Commander Trestrel Annual Appreciation Society later this week. In this special Christmas On the Ball, we ask, why is Ian St. John making a prick of himself in the Spanish sunshine? There's a guest appearance from Brian Moore, the man you love to hit.
Not picking on Gerald Kevin.
And a top television director comes clean, bearing all for On the Ball. Well, first of all, I must explain to you why your regular host, Ian St. John, isn't here with you today. Ian stayed very close to home up there on Merseyside as a personal guest of Her Majesty. In fact, he's in Walton Jail at the moment after pleading guilty to the wanton destruction of the Liverpool trophy room at Anfield.
It's ironic that Liverpool clinched both these trophies with wins against Tottenham last season. And you can be sure of one thing, Spurs... Fucking hell.
Well, I'm just having news handed to me here now that Ian, in fact... has done a deal with the prison governor up there at Walton. Nike tracksuits and briefcases are said to have been involved. But Ian has been transferred from Walton to La Corona in Spain. In fact, I'm hearing now he's in the exercise yard at this moment, and we can join him there now.
Welcome to the Resource Stadium here in La Corona. The groundsman is going to just walk by any minute, painting this white line up. A touchline is going to cock the whole thing up. And there's no enough noise here, is there? Oh, for fuck. We're now getting the marching bands, the mass bands of the Grenadier Guards. Fucking, can we get the PA turned down? And the fucking daft. And hell! I mean, that's fucking ridiculous, isn't it?
What a pity nobody's watching it.
Well, despite that, Brian, On the Ball's gone worldwide this season to try and bring you the best stories every Saturday, including a trip to Turin in northern Italy. Behind me, the city of Turin in northern Italy. Really not the sort of place most of you would choose for your holidays. Industry is the city's... I'll start that again. I can't do that with Doris giving it plenty over there. Get rid of Mickey Mouse there, Ted. Chuck him over the bloody edge, will you? Behind me, the city of Turin in northern Italy. Really not the sort of place most of you would choose for your holidays. There are beauty spots, but industry is the city's lifeblood. It's the capital... Sorry, Naz. This is hacking your work in here, eh? Oh, bollocks, I'm not doing it anymore.
And it was here, in northern Italy, that Ted Ayling fulfilled every director's dream, to get out front and show just how it should be done.
Me, you cunt. Behind me here, the poxy city of Turin. We've been sent here to do a story about football. Fuck knows what football happens here, I can tell you. However, there are two clubs, Torino and Juventus. I don't know who plays for either of them or why we're here, but it's bloody good here in the sun, in the bar, when you've had a few drinks.
Come on, keep going. Come on.
Anyway, this city is full of beauty spots. The Fiat factory, public toilets and other places that everybody wants to see. And we've done a few stories with a few foreigners who didn't speak English. And I hope they're very nice, because it's cost a bloody fortune.
You've got to carry them away, yeah?
Well, we'll have more from Ted a little later on.
I can reveal to you now that the big match is going to change its image in 1983. In an effort to boost the ratings, my colleague and friend Brian Moore has been working very hard in secret at a brand new act. In fact, he's gone back to the original presenter of the programme to get a few tips, and he's been talking to one of our top entertainers as well.
I could be a hilly now, couldn't I? Can you not make me a hilly? Good evening.
What about referees?
Referee. Well, I saw an Irish referee, you know, and he called the two football captains together, and he said, "There, listen, fellas," he said, "there's some fog coming down, so we'll have to play extra time first."
Tell me, which sportsman has given you more pleasure than any other in 74?
Oh, you are awful, but I like you.
Now we're going to take a very short break. There's still plenty to look forward to, including our entry for the Channel 4 Sporting Documentary Prize. Stay with us for that.
Christmas wonderland at Woolworths. So many things to choose from. Come and see the Chevrolet Red.